Hi, I'm Evan, and this is the shadow display. It's a 3D printed static object that displays two different black and white images when illuminated from two different specific angles. It's programmatically generated with a web app I created, and you can create your own by uploading two simple images and 3D printing the output. In this video, I'm going to explain how it works, and I'm going to show you how to use a web app so you can create your own. All right, so let's start with how it works. Let's say you want to create these two simple images. The one on the left will be created when illuminated from the left, and the one on the right will be created when illuminated from the right. I'm drawing these images next to each other, but remember, these two images are actually going to occur in the same location, so a single pixel could be two different colors when illuminated from the right versus the left. To simplify, let's look at a single row of pixels at a time. Let's say this is the row you've chosen. When illuminated from the left, you produce that red row, but when illuminated from the right, you produce the green row. Let's start with the pixel on the left. How can we create a topography that can cast a shadow there? Well, one way is to create an up ledge, like this. As you can see, when illuminated from the right, it will cast a shadow exactly where we want it. Let's continue. Between the next two pixels, we have the opportunity to add a new ledge. This ledge has to illuminate the green pixel, but cast a shadow on the red one. A down ledge does that perfectly. As you can see, when illuminated from the right, that green pixel is lit up, but when illuminated from the left, a shadow is cast in the perfect location. Let's keep going. Now we have two illuminated pixels. The solution for this is no ledge at all. As you can see, when illuminated from the right, we have light, and when illuminated from the left. Now we have two dark pixels. The solution here is to have a wall. As you can see, when illuminated from the right, it casts a shadow in the correct location, just like when you illuminate it from the left. Now we have two light pixels. We've seen this one before. The solution is no ledge at all. Whenever we're trying to figure out what ledge to use, we're always looking at two pixels at a time. And since each of the two pixels has two states, dark and light, that makes four total combinations. As you can see, each one of the combinations is enumerated here, and you can see each of the four solutions. Now that we know how to solve a row, all we have to do is apply that same logic to every row in the puzzle to find the full topography of the full 3D object. And that's the entirety of how it works. Now I want to show you how to create your own with your own images. Start by following the link in the description. That'll bring you to the project's Thingiverse page. Go ahead and click Open in Customizer, and here's the web app. Now you're going to need to tell it what your printer's nozzle size is. Smaller nozzle sizes work better, but most printers come with a 0.4 millimeter nozzle size. And then go ahead and upload your left and right images. As you can see, the 3D object is already generated and you can preview it to the right. Now click Create Thing. Name it, choose if you want to publish it or get an email, and click Create Thing again. Go ahead and open the queue, and then you're going to have to wait around 5 minutes while this thing processes. After that, you can just download it and print it and you're good to go. Now I want to talk about issues with the project and possible areas for improvement. Remember the four types of ledges? The wall type kind of sucks. First of all, it's created in between two dark pixels, so you want it to be as dark as possible. But the top of the wall is not infinitely narrow, and therefore will catch some light right where you don't want it. Additionally, the plastic is not 100% opaque, so a thin wall will let a little bit of light through, again, right where you don't want it. Alright, that's the video. Thanks for watching, and subscribe if you want to encourage me to make more useless stuff.